Hi everyone, in this video we see the questions which have been asked in TRB 2017 in electromagnetic field. The first question is, a lossless transmission line having characteristic impedance of 100 ohm is connected to a load of 200 ohm. What is the voltage reflection coefficient? So what they have given? They have given characteristics impedance Z0 is equal to 100 ohm and they gave Z L load impedance equal to 200 ohm. So we know that standing wave ratio is given by gamma, that is equal to ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. So it is ZL 200, Z0 100 divided by ZL 200 plus Z0 100, that is equal to 1 by 3. So the answer is 1 by 3. Next question, which of the following statements are true? See, all the statements are talking about dominant mode. The dominant mode is a mode which has lowest cutoff frequency. So the option A is a correct answer, right? So dominant mode has lowest cutoff frequency. It's a general definition. Like that, we have to remember another one definition, that is known as evanescent mode. Evanescent. They may ask this question also. Evanescent mode means, suppose for a mode with a frequency less than cutoff frequency, what will happen in waveguide is, the field components will decay exponentially and wave cannot propagate through that waveguide. That mode is called evanescent mode. So evanescent mode is a mode, it has a frequency less than cutoff frequency. This will lead to the decay of field component, hence the wave cannot be propagated. So that is another one definition you must know. Next we go to next question. In an airline, adjacent maxima are found at 12.5 centimeter and 37.5 centimeter. Find the operating frequency. So adjacent mode, adjacent maxima they have given. So one maxima at 12.5 and another maxima at 37.5. So what is the distance between these two? It is 25 centimeter. So the distance between adjacent maxima is 25 centimeter. We know the formula for adjacent maxima is lambda by 2. So the distance between the two maxima is lambda by 2. Similarly, the distance between maxima and minima is lambda by 4. So we got distance between two maxima or adjacent maxima, that is 25 centimeter. This implies lambda is equal to 50 centimeter, right? So lambda is equal to 50 centimeter. What is the thing they ask? They ask frequency. Frequency is equal to C by lambda. So 3 into 10 power 8 divided by 50 into 10 power minus 12, sorry, 2. So 50 into minus 2 centimeter. So that will give 600 megahertz. So the option B is a right answer. 600 megahertz is a correct answer. Next one, a rectangular waveguide axis. We know that waveguide is a high pass filter because it is used to pass the frequency above some frequency range, whereas transmission line is a low pass filter, right? It is passing some low frequency, it has some limit, so beyond that it cannot pass. Whereas what is the waveguide is, it will pass the frequency range above some frequency, that is highest frequency we are using waveguide. So it is a high pass filter, that is very important. Transmission line may act as a low pass filter. Next question, a rectangular waveguide with the dimension A is equal to 2.5 centimeter and B is equal to 1 is to operate below 15.1 gigahertz. Calculate the cutoff frequency for TE01 mode of the waveguide. given epsilon is equal to 4 epsilon naught, mu r is equal to 1 and sigma is equal to 0. So we have to calculate cutoff frequency. So cutoff frequency, before we find what they ask is, we have to find cutoff frequency fc. What they gave is a is equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 2, b is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 2, epsilon 4 epsilon naught, and mu r is equal to 1. These are all the things they have given, right? So we know that the cutoff frequency formula is fc is equal to v by 2 root of m by a whole square plus n by b whole square. This we know. Now we have to find m is given. M is TE 0, 1 they are given. So m is 0, n is equal to 1. Right? So because TE 0, 1, here m 0, n is 1. So m we know, n we know, a we know, b we know. What we have to find is v. V is, we know that v is equal to 1 by root mu epsilon. That is equal to 1 by root mu naught epsilon naught mu r epsilon r, right? So mu naught epsilon naught I take up 1 by root of mu naught epsilon naught divided by root of mu r epsilon r. This is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 we know, and mu r 1 epsilon r is 4 epsilon naught, right? So that they have given. So what is the thing? Epsilon r is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Sorry, epsilon r they have given. That is epsilon into epsilon r. So epsilon is 4 epsilon naught they have given. So substitute that value and what we get, sorry, I don't have any page, so I erase this. So 3 into 10 power 8, mu r I substituted 1, and epsilon naught I substituted, epsilon r I substituted 4 epsilon naught into, right? So that's what I substitute. Then if you simplify that, what I get is, this will be 4. So that is equal to, let me erase this, or I erase here. Right? Right. So V is equal to 1 by root of mu naught epsilon naught divided by root of 4 epsilon naught mu r. So if you simplify, what you get is, this is 3 into 10 power 8, this is 2, right? So epsilon r into mu r, epsilon r is 1, mu r is equal to 1. So what we get is 3 by 2 is 1.5 into 10 power 8. That is my v. Now we substitute the form. So we got is 1.5 into 10 power 8. So fc is equal to v by, so 1.5 into 10 power 8 divided by 2 m0, so that part will be cancelled. N is 1, n by b, so b is 1 in 10 power minus 2, that is 1 centimeter. So if you simplify, what you get is 0.75 into 10 power 10, that is equal to 7.5 gigahertz. So the answer is 7.5 gigahertz.